Hey guys, press the bell icon and never miss a video from Geekyvijay.
Almost 72 years ago, during the final stage of World War II, the United States dropped two nuclear weapons on Japanese cities, Hiroshima and Nagasaki. These bombings killed at least 1,30,000 people and remain the only use of nuclear weapons for the warfare in history. But what happens if Nepal is attacked by nuclear weapons? Let's find it out. First of all, let me introduce you all to our new video series Ramailo. Here series ma we gonna share interesting facts on various topics that every Nepali must know. Hope you guys will enjoy our brand new series. Now let's get back into the topic. So why should Nepal fear from nuclear attacks? Well, the easiest answer is because it is surrounded by two powerful countries bearing nuclear weapons. China and India are the nations with the nuclear weapons. China sanga 260 wata nuclear weapons chha bhane, India sanga 110 dekhi 120. Tesai gari Pakistan sanga 120 dekhi 130, Israel sanga around 80. And tesai gari North Korea sanga less than 10 nuclear weapons sa. With around 15,000 nuclear weapons remaining in the world, Russia has the largest stockpile of 7,000 nukes, followed by USA with 6,800 nuclear weapons. Nepal, a small landlocked country, does not have any nuclear weapons, but it does have raw materials like uranium, which can be used for making nuclear weapons. More on that later on. With the increasing political tension around the world, people are terrified of Third World War and use of nuclear weapons. Many people are keen to know about the effects of nuclear weapons and method to survive nuclear war. So today, we're gonna see what will happen if nuclear bomb is dropped in Nepal. First of all, the impact of nuclear bomb depends on many factors like weather, weapon design, geographical location of where the bomb hits, and if it's exploding air or hits the ground. After the nuclear bomb explodes, approximately 35% of energy comes in the form of thermal radiation or heat. Since the thermal radiation travels at approximately the speed of light, the flash of light and heat come several seconds before the blast wave, much like lightning, and this causes flash blindness to anyone looking the blast. Flash blindness is a temporary blindness of few minutes. However, experts suggest not to look at the blast directly because it can damage your eyesight in long term. Let's take an example of 1 megaton nuclear weapon, which is around 80 times larger than Hiroshima bomb, but much smaller in compared to the modern existing bombs. When such a powerful 1 megaton nuclear bomb explodes, people at 21 kilometers away from the blast can experience flash blindness on a clear day and even 85 kilometers on a clear night. That means if South bomb explodes in Kathmandu on a clear day, then people at Bhaktapur, Patan, Kirtipur, Chandragiri, Swayambhu, Tokha and places surrounding the valley can experience flash blindness. And if the bomb explodes on a clear night, then people at Nuwakot, Dhuli, Khel, Milamchi can experience the flash blindness. Thermal radiation burns occur to the people closer to the ground zero or the target area. First degree burns will occur to the people at 11 km from the ground zero. Second degree burns will occur to the people at 10 km. And third degree burns destroying skin tissues occur to the people at 8 km from the ground zero. That is, if the bomb explodes in Kathmandu, people of Kathmandu and Patan are likely to suffer from the third degree burns, whereas people at Bhaktapur and Kirtipur are likely to suffer from second and first degree burns. To make it clear, third degree burns that cover over 24% of the body is likely to be fatal without quick medical care. Furthermore, since the valley is surrounded by hills and mountains, there is high chances of minimum effect to the people outside the valley. The center temperature of Hiroshima explosion was estimated to be around 300,000 degrees Celsius, which is over 300 times hotter than the temperature the bodies are cremated at. This intense heat is enough to reduce a body to its basic elements. That is, if such bomb explodes in Kathmandu, there will be no sign of people living in Patan and Kathmandu. There will be no dead bodies. Not even a single bone will be left. That sounds horrible, right? Likewise, the radiation of the blast also behaves like sunlight. So objects will cast shadow where the radiation doesn't hit directly. When a nuclear bomb explodes, most of the energy is released in blast, which drives away air from the site of explosion, creating sudden changes in air pressure and can rush objects or knock them down. Let's take the example of 1 megaton bomb. If such bomb explodes, then within a 6 km radius, there would be an estimated 180 tons of force on the wall of any two-storied buildings with wind speed of 255 km per hour. Within 1 km radius, the peak pressure will be 4 times greater and wind speed can reach up to 756 km per hour. There is no way a human body can endure this amount of pressure. However, the winds would create fatal collisions with the nearby objects, so deaths would largely be from the collapsed buildings. All these effects with 1 megaton bomb. Now just compare it with largest nuclear bomb ever detonated. The 50 megaton Tsar Bomba dropped on isolated island in Russia is similar to the 3,333 Hiroshima bombs combined. Can you imagine that? While most of the energy is released during the blast, there is high chances of more survival if the bomb explodes in the valley like Kathmandu. Since Kathmandu is surrounded by tall hills and mountains, people living outside the valley have more chances of survival from the blast because the hills and mountains can act as a natural barriers to reduce the impact of blast waves. But now there is another problem. Radiation. First of all, we must know not all the radiations are harmful. We are exposed to different forms of radiation every day like our phones. But ionizing radiation at the center of nuclear bomb has enough energy to rip the electrons from the atom. Thus, radiation is another major aspect you need to worry about. Exposure to the 600 REM radiation has 90% chance of creating fatal illness, while exposure to 450 REM radiation is estimated to have 50% chance of fatality. But even those who recover suffer from long term. Radiation of nuclear explosion can break the molecular bone and strands of DNA. Most of the DNA can repair themselves, but quarter of them don't, which results in a future genetic mutation and increase the probability of cancer. The another harmful aspect of nuclear bomb explosion is the fallout. When a bomb is detonated on or near the surface of the earth, the blast creates the crater and materials that used to be deposited in a crater is carried up to the air as vaporized dirt particle forming the familiar mushroom cloud. These particles become radioactive and eventually condensed and come back down as fallout. So, fallout can be more dangerous than the actual blast waves as it can travel far from the blast site, spreading the radiation and harm the people in long term. Depending on the wind conditions, the radioactive fallout can travel for hundreds of kilometers, and though it can fall in the form of black rain for most part, you can't detect fallout with your senses. Luckily, fallout radiation decays very quickly, and within 2 weeks, radioactive material will have declined to about 1% of its initial radiation level. So, it is suggested to stay in shelter for around 2 weeks to avoid harmful radioactive fallouts. अहिलेसम्म हामीले नेपालमा एउटा न्युक्लियर बम पड्क्यो भने के हुन्छ होला भनेर हेर्यौँ, तर यदि 100 न्युक्लियर बम पड्क्यो भने के हुन्छ होला, अथवा पुरै विश्वमा न्युक्लियर वार सुरु भयो भने के हुने होला? इट्स कन्सिडर्ड 100 न्युक्लियर बम एक्सप्लोजन्स. If 100 nuclear bombs are exploded in Nepal in various places, then there is a high probability of Nepal disappearing from the world map. If 100 nukes are exploded in Nepal, then not only Nepal gets affected, but the entire South Asian countries need to face the problems. After the blast, 5 megaton of black carbon would immediately enter the atmosphere, causing global temperature to fall and receive 9% less rain annually. Though these changes sound small, they could be enough to trigger crop failures and famine. According to the studies, it is estimated that 2 billion people will starve when 100 nuclear weapons go off. Well, the condition of the world would be apocalyptic. Let's hope we need not to face this condition. But as we all know, world is uncertain, and if you need to face any nuclear explosion, what will you do? Well, check out our another video to know the answer. Hope you enjoyed. That's it for this time. Subscribe if you haven't, and don't forget to like and share this video. Good time.